let's now focus on the dimension that Brandom sees as crucial in Hegel's project of reconciliation, the dimension of what Brandom calls forgiving recollection. In recollection, you should, of course, discern the dimension indicated by the German word Erinnerung, which means memory, but not this mechanical Gedächtnis. Memory is just remembering the past, but recollecting in the sense of Erinnerung, rendering it internal, translating external contingency into its inner logic, conceptual form, and so on and so on. Hegel deployed this notion of forgiving recollection. An evil act can be forgiven if it's properly recollected. Towards the end of the chapter on spirit, Geist, in his Phenomenology of Spirit. Let's now go a little bit into it. The gap that separates the acting subject, and for Hegel, when you act, you commit a crime, you always sin in some sense. The gap that separates the acting subject and this subject's severe judge who points out the crime, the particular interest that guided the acting subject, is there overcome through their reconciliation, when not only the agent, the active subject, confesses his sin, but the judge also confesses the unilaterality of his own position, his participation in what he condemns. Hegel says this in a wonderful way. He writes, evil is also, resides also in the gaze which sees evil everywhere around itself. Brandom's notion of forgiving recollection, I think, is very useful today. It enables us to see what is false in precisely those who advocate tolerance and who reject hate speech. Is today an exemplary case of a rigid moral judgment not a politically correct procedure, which sternly condemns those who are accused of practicing hate speech? We all know how swift and cruel such judgments can be. One wrong word, one joke considered inappropriate, and your career can be in ruins. Let me give you some examples. I already used them. I'm sorry if you know them. Remember what recently happened to the film critic David Edelstein. Apropos the death of Bernardo Bertolucci, Edelstein made a rather tasteless joke on his private Facebook page. A joke with regard to the death to, again, with regard to Bertolucci and Last Tango in Paris. He wrote, even grief is better with butter. Of course. And he referred here to the famous, it's not a hardcore, just played, not really enacted, scene of anal sex where Marlon Brando, so it is indicated, put some butter into Maria Schneider's rectum. And then Edelstein quickly deleted this sentence before the public outcry broke out, not as a reaction to public outcry. He immediately saw he made the mistake and deleted this, even grief is better with butter. But then actress Martha Plimpton immediately tweeted it to her followers with a message, fire him immediately. which happened the next day. Fresh Air and NPR announced that they were cutting ties with Edelstein because the post had been offensive and unacceptable, especially given Maria Schneider's experience during filming of Last Tango in Paris. So what are the implications, or rather the unstated rules of this incident? I refer here to Laura Kipnis from Chicago, who noted that first, that's not her position, that's how he describes the stance which demands...